Autism can be a very sensitive topic, of course, very serious topic. It can also be, autism can be the way that Snoop Dogg pronounces the word autumn as well. Autism. I do a lot of impressions. But I will do a few more to cleanse the palate of that one. This next impression is Sean Connery as a librarian.
Shush.
Okay, so that's that one. Appreciate it. It's pretty good. Does anybody think maybe his name is really Sean Connery and we're just understanding him wrong?
Sean, I say. Sean. I said Sean.
This next impression is going to be a Scooby-Doo on a college campus warning women where not to go in order to avoid being sexually assaulted via the use of roofies. I'll give it to you one more time. This might be the longest setup to shortest impression in history, I think. Scooby-Doo on a college campus warning women where not to go in order to avoid being sexually assaulted via the use of roofies. Frat row! Okay, so that's that one. That's, I appreciate that. This next impression is the first scientist. What's that? Okay, that's that one. Thank you, that's fine, thank you. This next impression is Snoop Dogg again. I don't have a very large range. This time as a Batman villain. Rizzle me this. Okay, that's that one. Now, I think I'll do one more impression now, but also later in the show, there might be a secret mystery impression. You won't even know it was one until after. I'm like, and that was the secret mystery impression. It'll blow your minds. They're not blown now, because it hasn't happened yet. But I'm just fluffing your minds right now. Later, I'll totally suck your mind's dick completely. It's weird that a fluffer means what it is, and nuts are what they are, but Fluffernutter is a sandwich for children. Anyway, I'm gonna get back to my grandmother shortly, but finally, last impression for now. This is a child in the backseat of a time machine. Child in the backseat of a time machine. Are we then yet? Okay, so that's that one. That one might be my most successful tweet to joke conversion, I think. Maybe second only to butt dial. That's the kind of soap I use on my butt. And I'm not sure if everybody knows that dial is a soap, but. Okay, so only one more thing about Twitter. You got it. I tweeted a joke a couple years ago, and a man wrote back. He said, I've been following you on Twitter for over a year since I saw you on Conan, and you finally tweeted something funny. Which seems mean, but also, it's kind of more complex than that. It's like a roller coaster. It's like, is it nice? Is it mean? Who knows? Because he saw me on TV and liked me and started following my career for over a year, despite not enjoying it for any portion of that year. Every night he went to bed, I assume, thinking, maybe tomorrow. Tomorrow will be the day. It's a story about the perseverance of the human spirit. Eternal optimism. Hope that was eventually rewarded with a joke that he deemed best of the year. And what was that joke? It was mild-mannered toilet by night. Superhero bidet. That was the joke that the guy thought was the greatest of all. Oh, you guys. You don't have to agree with him. You needn't. You mustn't. You can. I'm not saying I thought it was the best.